It's Dave, and Dave's Life Over 65. Just in case some of you are wondering why I'm always wearing this bandana, it's one of three that I use. The reason I'm wearing it now inside is because I'm fighting off a cold which has been bugging me for the last 2 weeks or more, and I get cold. I got my hair cut, and every time I do that, I catch a cold, only this one just doesn't want to go away. So that's why I'm wearing the bandana. It's not a fashion statement. Plus, here in Toronto, the temperatures have been... we had a wind chill of minus... so they say, we had a wind chill of minus 28 today. Which means it was pretty damn cold. Anyways, the reason I'm having this video today is because I discovered a neat little thing in the dollar store. You know, you can find some real treasures in dollar stores. I'm sure the dollar stores in your area would have something like this. And as you can see, it's $1.25 for 12 pieces. 3/4 are 12. And you break them in, and anyways, I've even broken them farther so that they'll fit in this bottle. Probably make another. Probably make a fire starter kit. I want to have a ferrocelum rod, fire steel, in other words, some kind of a pocket knife, and a bunch of stuff. Just for the point, maybe some char cloth. I've never worked with char cloth, but after watching just about everybody in the survival community talk about it, maybe it's not a bad idea. Anyways, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to make up a fire starter kit, which I can take with me. These little cubes, and it's basically each cube, as you can see, is pretty big. And that would burn for a long time, I think. I set one of these on fire earlier. Well, not one of these, but I scraped a little bit of fuzz off this. Nice thing about these are they're very easy to make fuzzy. If you can see on this one, those black marks are from fire steel. I just wanted to see if I could start it up like it is. And I imagine if I kept at it, I might have got it going. But why bother? As I showed you in other videos, it's a lot easier to get something going if it's got little fuzzy things. And as I explained before, the reason for that is that if you can get like small, like almost microscopic strands of combustible material, and get them separated, it's much easier to catch a spark and start. And then once the heat catches on, then the whole thing goes up. So let me show you what I'm talking about. Okay, so here's my quarter of one of those little cubes. And my little dinky-dinky little EDC knife. Now, it's real easy. You just take your knife. There you can see, and just scrape it. Now what these are is very fine according to the blurb on the package. These are very fine sawdust particles which have been dipped in wax and compressed, or maybe they were compressed and dipped in wax, I don't know. But anyways, They're wax-infused shavings. And they make a nice little soft cube. Nice little tinder bundle. Now, if you had a magnifying glass and it was in the sun and it was very sunny, you could easily. I can feel the wax. It's got a lot of wax on it. Okay. Of course, I could take this and just, and it would burn real quick. But let's make it a little more difficult. Let's take my old Buck Selkirk and remove the ferrous alum rod. And don't yell at me because I'm using the blade to strike a spark. That's because this is not a 90 degree angle, and it's a lot of work to make it a 90 degree angle. So I'm going to just use the blade. So you could do this. That doesn't work. What I've discovered from watching the pros, or the successful amateurs, is to put the rod right in the source. One strike. Shit, I should have been timing this. And there's virtually no damage to the knife. Once you get the fuzz going, look how easy that catches. And that throws off a fair amount of heat. I can actually see the wax melting and becoming liquidy. Thing is, once you got your tinder going, your kindling, I guess, because this is the tinder. See, look at that. I don't know if you can see that. Where the hell is the light taking this? But that's wet. That's like melted wax. The nice thing about this is, I can use it again and again and again. All I have to do is scrape up. Now, what I would do if I was going to use this for starting a fire is I would make a little bit of fuzz here. Put the ferrous alum rod down on it. If you don't rough it up and make a little bit of fuzz, it doesn't want to catch very easily. Let me trim this wet area here. See, it just doesn't want to start. But 5 on it. Obviously the optimal amount. Can you see what I'm doing? Possible I didn't make enough fuzz, because as you see, the first time I did this, that's going to mess up your blade, but that's easily fixed. There we go. Yeah, the blade's pretty. Must have been how I did it the last time. Anyways, that's it. Anyways, take care, be safe, and if you haven't already done so, please subscribe so I know you're there, and hit the bell so that you know that whenever I post a new video, it will let you know.